When you're looking for scholarly resources to support your research paper, you should also think about how research articles can present information differently within disciplines as well as between different disciplines. In general, scholarly articles in the sciences and social sciences consist of those that are conducting a study or experiment and those that are reviewing and analyzing other studies. Here are some of the features you can use to identify a research study, also called empirical research due to the collection of primary data. These articles present original research collected by the authors. They are broken down into sections, so it is easy to navigate through the article and know what each section is presenting. Charts and graphs are often included to illustrate the data. In a literature review, the author is reading and assessing the research of a number of scholars. Literature review articles are usually identified as such and may or may not have the typical section headings of other research articles. Literature reviews can also be called systematic reviews, which follow a more systematic analysis of research articles. Reviews summarize the research being done on a specific topic into one article. Review articles also identify gaps in the research and opportunities for further research. Review articles are excellent for directing readers and you, as a student, to a number of potentially useful resources in your own research. It is worth pointing out that research or empirical articles can have sections incorporating a literature review, but it is a method of establishing background before launching into the study. It is not the entire article as we are looking at here. While distinguishing between studies and reviews can be generalized in the sciences and social sciences, articles in the arts and humanities usually look a little different. In general, arts and humanities articles are not conducting an experiment or collecting data from a number of other sources. Instead, the author is presenting an analysis of a topic, such as a literary work, a piece of art, or another scholar's ideas. There are no prescriptive layouts or section headings for arts and humanities articles like in the sciences, but like any academic paper, it follows a certain format and order, as you can see here. Articles in the arts and humanities generally consist of the author-scholar providing an analysis of an issue supported by references or in contrast to another scholar's work. The use of charts and graphs is usually not needed, though they may appear in some arts and humanities articles, as well as photos or images. This is not to say that arts and humanities scholars are lacking in the creation of original information, yet they are working with thoughts and information in a more abstract manner. Here is an example of an article from the sciences where you can see the layout and the presence of the headings and charts. And here is an example of an article from the humanities that doesn't follow the same heading layout as the sciences. This article also lacks images, charts, and graphs. Notice, however, that each article has quite a few references or works cited at the end, meaning all these sources were referred to in the creation of these articles. These are always useful to lead you from one relevant article to the next. If you have more questions, head to the library's main page at library.georgiasouthern.edu, where you can find contact information, chat with a librarian, or set up a research appointment.